Alright, good morning. Now today I'm going to talk about the woo woo, little Yorkie I Love You campaign a little bit. It's just something I came up with on the spur of the moment. A friend of mine has a little Yorkie, and there it was, and it's so darling. And I said, woo woo, little Yorkie, I love you. And after I said it on the type and the text, I'm like, oh my gosh, that's like something, you know, they would have for New York. You know, I love New York, you know, the Big Apple. That's a very cute one, because you can use that saying, you can put it on women's panties, yeah, you can put it on your t-shirts. And it also is good for dogs, for the little dogs. So it tells the world that the New York itself has a mascot, and the mascot is the little Yorkie. So that would be kind of a fun campaign. Since we're just inundated with all of this terrible dog problem over there in Asia, with the dog markets, and 12 million of them are raised and killed and tortured. So many of them are tortured before they're actually used for food, because the sacrifice moment apparently is some extra benefit for your health. I mean, this is what we're dealing with. We're just dealing with some real backwards brains, and the 12 million that are dead every year, many of them are tortured, like literally crucified. They put nails through their paws. So I am just, you know, there's nothing we can do except elevate how much we love dogs here in America, here in the Europe. We have to elevate how much we love and adore them. And there, that type of thing. Have little slogans for your city. San Francisco, you need one also for your heart. There, you know, lift my heart in San Francisco, you need a dog slogan. So all of these things will help stop these incredibly backward people. So yeah, that's where I'm at right now. I'm just thinking of the campaign slogans. And yes, you can put them on, I mean, think about it, especially little women, shorts, tiny women in New York. It would be the cutest little thing to give one of them, you know, as a gift, some kind of clothing, you know what I mean? Actually, for the man, it would be for the man, huh? He would wear it, and so she could read it. It's, yeah, that reciprocation moment. Of silly t-shirts and of underwear, if you go to bed, that type of thing. Yeah, that's what I was thinking about with it. But yeah, and so because I have this informatica, I don't know if that's a true term, but a friend, and she is like, who is this? Miss Mary Mack with all the buttons down her back. She's like the live one, you know, she's the live animation style creative human. And because she's a creative animated type extrovert, my gosh, she's so funny. She put the dog on her head. She put the little Yorkie on her head as part of a wig, and he just lays there for her as her beautiful little toy. And she goes on the airplanes that way with her dog. And I mean, this type of thing, these type of people are hysterical to me. And that, you know, if we can keep that humor, you know, just as long as it's not a dead one up there, is keep the humor, because it seems like that's what happens. You walk over and you get over to the colds of Russia, and it turns into the dead skunk on your head, or the dead this on your head, and then, because it's cold, I understand it's cold, but we have many other fibers now, and wool is wonderful. It's been wonderful for years. Down, I don't want to talk about down, but yeah, wool. We'll just say wool. Let's share wool, everybody. It doesn't really hurt the animals. It's just a regular barber shop quartet. That's it. It does not hurt them. And they're happy. They're like woo after it's all gone. They leap around like they're young lambs again, and they're So Russia just needs to develop their sheep herding skills. That will help also get out all of that fur trade business. Is develop their sheep herding skills, bring in species from the cold species, more enigmatic to that region. And so those types of things will help make the shift away from fur. You know, you have to get away from fur to what you're going to wear in the cold. So you're going to wear lots and lots of wool. And there's Angora wool made from the Angora sheeps. There's very beautiful wools. So there. Look at the Scots. They've for many years they've made wonderful blankets, and they have the finest fibers imaginable out of wool. So we need to start getting those regions to really shift. You just go into the happy sheep trade, and that will be a lot better for their human self in the next life as well as this one. So yeah, woo woo, little Yorkie, I love you. Yeah, I know I'm sounding serious now, but that adorable little Yorkshire Terrier, you know, make him your mascot. And now don't confuse the issue and throw all the dogs there. This is New York and they're all walking in the park at once. Just make one mascot and have another city that has their mascot. Yeah. Okay, so, and then I don't know what to say about the people that are heroes. There are heroes there. They go out there to those markets, they get this information and they bring it to us. They are just heroes of today. They are brave people, and we have to applaud them and just be, they're incredible. I saw this man that does this, there was a woman there, and that's what they do. They go and they gather this information, they bring it back to us, and just awful. It's just awful, isn't it? Anyway, so that's really what this video was about. Yeah, and so when you when we're playing with the animals, you know, putting them on our head as a hat, you know, that is supposed to be fun instantly to people, and they're supposed to know this. But sometimes people don't, and they're dumb, and they use animals as some kind of a circus event, as a trick. And you get up there and you do it this way, and so you have to be careful, because there are those types of people. We can't just have fun, can we? Because there are people that are what do we call it, when they're straight as a demand. Anyhoots, that's all. So we want to have these dogs happy. And maybe that's it. You know, maybe Georgia, the state of Georgia, needs to really relegate a state dog. The state of Florida, their special cities, you know. Welcome to the dog state of Chihuahua. I mean, obviously, you know, these types of things have to happen. You know, we just have to make fun. You know, make a second state name even. You know, you're California. Well, what's your second state name? You know, what's your real dog name? You know, this is the year of the dog. This is the year of the dog. Let's respect the dog. We love them. We love their loyalties. We love what they give. They're good for our health, our hearts. They lower our blood pressures. They love us unconditionally. You know, we feed them, and we give them walks, you know, let's have the same, let's have a, you know, what's your state is New Mexico. Well, give it a dog state name also. You know, all of these things help lift the human psyche away from the belittlements and the intimidations and the ridicules that they give the animals. The more compassion state gets lifted. So what would Texas be, for example? Oh my gosh, it is so windy here right now. I have to wear like hats around my head to protect the hair. It is the windiest place. I cannot believe it. I am just like woed out. I wanted to work in the garden, but I can't even go out there sometimes. It's just, and I planted these cutesy little roses, and I'm so sorry for them. They're having to put up with it. Mean sky. Yeah, so I don't know. Yeah, what kind of dog would be the state dog, you know, would be your city dog? So you can have a state dog, and you'll be like, maybe, wow, you could be the Rottweiler state, I don't care. But maybe your city dog is a Chihuahua, and that would be funny. And then you could have sister cities all over the world. And so you could have the Chihuahua city of Topeka, Kansas, and meet up with the Chihuahua city of Sudan. Sudan is not a city, Teresa. It would be Sudan. Oh my gosh, I can't even think of one right now over there. I'm sorry. Abu Dhabi. Abu Dhabi would be the other Chihuahua. So you could have the sister Chihuahuas. That's so much funner in a way, anyway. And so that's another way that we bring the animal perspective across the world, where, hey, you know, this is Year of the Dog, so let's do something fun for them.